So where does Kanye West go when he wants to find an amazing opening act? He doesn't look any further than downtown Toronto. We're here at the Drake. We're going to talk to Melanie Fiona. She's an amazing artist with a new album coming out called The Bridge. Kanye loves her. I love her. And guess what? You're going to love her too. Okay, okay. He's got my number red. You can, you can. Want me, baby, here I am. Either you make the time or just forget me. I'm very excited. You're very excited. New album. Let's talk about that.
Let's talk about it. It's coming out June 30th.
The countdown is on.
It's on. I'm so excited. I'm happy to be here for the release. It's home.
How nice is that?
God, it honestly feels so great being abroad so long and then being able to come home and celebrate it first here. It's great.
Now, abroad, you're touring with Kanye. How does that go down?
I mean, really, like, you're amazing.
Thank you.
How does Kanye sort of find you?
Kanye,
are you guys like this?
I wish. No, you know what? In my heart,
yeah,
Kanye and I,
totally.
We're BFFs forever. You know what? Kanye, he's somebody I've admired. He's somebody that I've followed his career. And I've always said, you know, I really want to work with Kanye eventually.
Yes.
And so my management knew he was going to do a tour. And they went to him and they're like, look, we've got this artist. My management was Roc Nation, which is Jay-Z and Jay Brown. And
that's
so they
not too shabby.
So you know, but Kanye is very particular. Like, he doesn't just say, hey, I'm going to co-sign. And even if it's for a favor, he doesn't do it. So they went to him like a real pitch. Like, look, we have this artist.
Yep.
This is her music. Tell us what you think. We think maybe, you know, we're hoping she could go on tour with you. He heard the music, loved it. 2 weeks later, I'm overseas in London. I got to meet him for the first time. I had no single out.
Give it to me right, or don't give it to me at all.
Yeah.
I want to know when someone did not give it to you right in any way.
Which one do you want to find? Find all of my ex-boyfriends. Which one do you want to find? Because they didn't give it to me right. That's why we're not together anymore. No, you know what?
They're all crying.
You know what it is? It's like, I really am so no-nonsense. And like, absolutely, I've definitely been in relationships where you're totally sideswiped by love and you don't make the right decisions all the time because you love someone so much. But my actual personality is no nonsense, and I'm just like, after a while, I'm smarter than emotional.
Yes.
I become more mental than emotional. So then after, you know, if something is not going right for me, I just have to make a better decision to do better for myself. So.
Now, are men, yes, they already know the answer to this, but I'm going to ask it anyway, are men intimidated by you? Do you know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah, I have a hard time meeting guys that I think are suitable for me type thing, especially being an artist, being on the road. You know, you have to find somebody who understands what you do. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I'm a pretty strong personality, and like, I'm not a wuss by any stretch of the imagination.
Watch out.
At all. I'm kind of a shark. I am. I can't lie. And like, I'm pretty tough. I'm a tough girlfriend.
You look it.
I am. I'm tough.
What are you looking forward to? Not like what experiences you've had, but what are you looking forward to most? Like, is there some sort of
plan that you have?
I am absolutely excited about touring the world. Being in Toronto, growing up here, it's so multicultural. You're exposed to so many different cultures, and you have so many people from walks of life that inspire you, and you learn about them. And I am enjoying traveling. I've been to Europe. I'm gonna go to Asia. Like, there's a world out there, and as many countries as I can get to through the music, that's my ultimate dream.